All right, sis, we're continuing Fitfluencer Week with one of YouTube's hottest fitness stars and his Athlete X Workout.
That's
Please
right.
welcome back to the show, strength coach and physical therapist, Jeff Cavalieri. Jeff, welcome back.
Yes.
Thanks for having me.
I mean, you have nearly 12 million followers and subscribers on YouTube. If I had to ask you, like, what the most popular workout is, like, what's the go-to?
I mean, arms are always popular.
I mean
people,
look at yours.
Well,
ladies, round of applause for his arms.
In any shirt you're wearing. So, you know, the thing about arms, though, is there's not a lot of variety when it comes to the exercises, but it's not always about what you're doing, it's how you're doing what you're doing, because that gives you better results if you know what you're doing, and also it gives you a kind of safer results.
So, now, you have veins the size of a hose. How do you get those? Because I'd like those as well.
Drink a lot of water.
Drink a lot of water. Is that
drink
the key?
And stay lean. You gotta stay lean. You have to, of course, you have to still stay lean. But
yeah,
you know, the first thing that we talk about with a safe exercise is oftentimes not so safe is a dip. So if you get down in this position, you've probably done this a million times, right?
Okay.
So you have two options. You can either do it with your feet flat on the floor, which makes it a little bit easier. Sissany, I think you should start with these. Okay?
And by the way, anybody watching, you should check with your doctor before you try any workout.
And Ryan,
Sissany, you too.
Add onto your heels, okay?
Okay, my heels.
Now, people don't think about their hand position, and we all just sort of just automatically grab like this. The problem is it puts your shoulder in a very vulnerable position, because when you get down to the bottom, it's very rounded. So what we want to do is open the hands up.
Why? Right?
Turn them out this way. Because what that does is it opens up
the
chest.
So put them flat on the bench.
Put them flat on the bench.
I never do that.
You've been doing them wrong our whole lives?
Right. So now when you come down, you still do it just to about 90 degrees. But when you come up, think about keeping that chest as open as you can.
Uh-huh.
Because now you've taken that shoulder and taken it from that vulnerable position to something that's much more safe.
And how many shirts do you own? Just one?
Just one.
Yeah. Right? All right. What about kickbacks?
All right.
So kickbacks. So again, another exercise. And a lot of times the bigger guys in the gym will avoid this because they think, oh, I can't get too heavy on
that's
this,
right.
you know? So it looks like this. You put your arms back behind your body,
uh-huh.
and you kick the weights back.
Okay.
But the key thing here is that you're hitting the triceps in a fully contracted state because the elbow is behind the body. It doesn't just cross the elbow, it crosses the shoulder too. So
well,
you
how
need
far
to get
back? You want to go all the way back?
Just get the arms back behind the body like that.
Okay, like that. There we go.
Back pain can become an issue
right.
as you enter that third trimester. So what you do is put one dumbbell down.
It's a modification.
You can start doing your version of it.
Oh, great.
You put one leg in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
Take the other one up like this and support yourself on your knee so you don't have to worry so much about your low back.
Yeah.
Right, but you still do the same thing. Nothing changes in terms of the mechanics of the exercise.
Just one at a time.
As long as, just one at a time.
Okay, can you guys hurry up?
yeah.
What's next?
Okay, so now we gotta talk about the other side of the arm. We're talking about the bicep. So we take up one dumbbell. And again, fully contracted is really an important thing we want to make
but one,
sure.
But one thing I heard you talk about is what you see is what you're working. Explain that.
So we're going to get to that with the dumbbell curl. But what you see, if I curl more with my arm in front of my body and you see the outside part of my arm, that's actually working something called the long head of the bicep. There's two heads of the bicep, hence its name. So it's the part that gives you more of the bicep peak. If I see the inside of the bicep when I curl, then I'm getting more of the short head, the inner side. So we can do kind of hit the long head with this because we take our hands underneath the dumbbell and we hold it straight down like this.
Right.
All right, and we keep our hands parallel to the ceiling at all times. Even at the bottom, you got to cup it. It's a little bit of a small dumbbell, but here, cup it and go straight up to the top. And you can feel the biceps really contract at the top because we're in that completely contracted state.
You can also feel it in your core a little bit too, can't you?
Anytime you have the weight out in front of your body there, you're going to have to make sure that you maintain tightness in your core. You're going to be leaning with it.
Yeah. I'm not at my full strength. I went bowling a couple days ago, so I've got a little bit of bowling elbow.
Okay,
here.
Disclaimer for him.
We're going to come back. We've got more tricks, bicep tricks, and others when we come back right after this. All right, Jeff Cavalieri.
We are back with Jeff Cavalieri. All right, what is next?
Well, you're going to use my weight, so you're welcome. Go ahead.
So we've all done bicep curls, right? But not a lot of us think whether or not it actually matters whether you do them together or one at a time. But it actually does. And especially here in your consideration, I would make sure that I do it one way versus the other.
Are you talking to me?
Yes.
He's talking to me, the pregnant woman.
What you want to do is you understand that curling these weights up also creates this challenge of our balance backwards, right? Because you're swinging weights up towards the behind us. So if you do one at a time, I've got 25 pounds in my hands, Ryan's weight, you know, you basically are controlling only 25 pounds in that direction. If I bring them together, now I've got 50 pounds going backwards that my core has to sort of stabilize.
I can feel the difference.
Right. So it doesn't compromise your biceps at all, whether you do them one or two.
But you get more out of it if you're doing two.
You're going to get more out of it if you do two, because you're going to get more of your core involved too. But if you're just looking to sort of train your biceps, you could do either. Giving it one arm at a time is going to let you focus a little bit more on that one arm.
Yeah, a little less pressure on your back.
Sissany loves to do hammer curls. So is she working the bicep or just the forearm?
So the more supinated you are with your hand turned up, the more biceps you get.
Yes.
The less of that you get, the more you get away from that. So that gets a muscle called the brachialis. It's underneath the bicep. Okay. If you go all the way overhand, you get more of the forearm here. Uh-huh. As opposed to the biceps.
Wow. So is it best to have a mirror when you're working out so you can kind of see all these angles of your body?
So that's the point that Ryan brought up before. Interestingly, what you see in the mirror is what you train. And again, the bicep is two parts. So if I'm curling here and I see the outside part of the bicep, I'm getting more of the long head of the bicep.
It kind of ruins it for me to have a mirror. I get distracted by my body.
Or discouraged, one or the other.
If you come this way, now you're getting the inside part of the bicep, which is more of the short head.
Yeah.
So again, if you want to focus a little bit more, you can't isolate, but if you want to focus a little bit more on one part than the other, outside is more of that peak, and then the inside is more of the fullness.
Okay, let's get to the shoulder circuit. I can't roll much more with mine, but you can show the rest of it.
Put one dumbbell down for a second.
Put one weight down?
One dumbbell down, yep. And you start with one. So there's three heads of the delts, front, middle, and rear. I want to hit them all in one little quick circuit, okay? So what we do is take the dumbbell in front of us. You're just gonna start pressing it out with two hands. Hold it on the dumbbell itself. There you go. Press straight out. Good. Up a little bit at an angle. Just like that. Yeah. So we're hitting the front delt. 5 reps.
Kelvin, these are called weights.
Yeah.
All right.
Good. Now pick up the other dumbbell quickly without rest.
Okay. Without rest.
The middle delt. Now we're gonna come up to the side in a side lateral raise.
Okay.
Make sure here that you're keeping your hands above your elbows.
I know. Come on. Come on. I'll put this on loop for you guys in the office.
So why did Ryan?
One more.
Why do you have 15 pounds and you have 25?
Because he's the certified trainer.
So then, without rest.
I'm uncertified.
We come back. Now we're gonna do a little bit of a high pull. Lean a little bit forward, just a little bit.
Okay.
And pull up here. Again, keep your elbows below your hands. Almost think about taking your thumbs and putting them back behind your body.
Okay. Surely this segment has gone too long, so. We'll just get to a break. Check out Jeff's Athlean X Workout on YouTube and Instagram. And up next, we open the inbox right after this. Jeff, thanks, bro.